Hello, hi, and welcome back to another video. Welcome back to Gussie Voyages. As you guys know, my name is Katu, and guess what time it is? Yes, indeed, it is that time because it's contract number 3, baby. Yes, contract number 3 loaded, and I'm packing. So, perfect time to shoot yet another video again of what to pack when you come and work on a cruise ship. So, stay tuned if you want to know what do you need to pack when you're working on cruise ships. Let's go. So these are the clothes that I have laid out. I've selected a few clothes. So what I did was I looked at the itinerary where the ship will be going in terms of, it's basically seasons. Okay, so we've got two different climates that we're going to. So hence the selection of clothing. So we're going to try fit all of this into the big luggage bag and we'll take it from there.
So this is my third contract. Now, on my first contract, I made massive mistakes because I just didn't know what to pack, how much to pack. When I came back, I realized that literally I only wore maybe 30%, if not 40% of what I took for my contract. So I wasted a lot of luggage space. Second contract, same mistake. You think you would learn, but no, I made the same mistake. And then also, you tend to buy a lot of stuff. So found that my bags were overweight and I had to pay for additional fees at the airport for overweight bags. So hopefully, fingers crossed that this third contract I am much wiser and I can make better choices in terms of what to pack so that I actually leave space if I'm looking to purchase stuff when I'm abroad, or just simply meet the weight requirements and try and take less bags.
So on a cruise ship, as crew members, we bring various stuff. Okay, first and foremost, uniform. Okay, uniform, you're gonna need uniform. Some departments don't have uniform, but me, myself, and I, as a personal trainer on board cruise ships, I have uniform. And my first contract, I actually realized I spent more time in my uniform rather than home clothes. Hence, they are so little. But then you also get like themed nights, themed crew parties. So like you might find that we have an African night party. So hence I took my African attire, represent Africa, let's go, yes, okay. On Royal Caribbean, when you go out and have dinner, you have to wear formal attire. So took some chinos, took some formal button-up shirt, some formal pants, black pants, keeping it nice and simple, yeah. There it is, different color, I don't want to be all too black. So a different color to make my skin color pop. Come on now. And then I personally, I don't like the cold. So I made sure that I take a couple of sweaters, two sweaters to be quite exact. Okay. And then two jerseys. And then from there, two like winter, like super cold winter jackets. Just in case I go to Alaska. You never know, you can get transferred from one ship to another, as it happened on my first contract. So you do have to stay prepared just in case you get transferred. So just in case I go to Alaska, I am prepared. And then as a personal trainer, I will be working out, I will be teaching classes, and after my shift, I will want to work out myself. So I took a whole lot of working out shirts, okay? I tend to sweat a lot, so yes indeed. And some shorts also, some swimming shorts, okay, quite important. They are quite versatile. So you can wear them when you're going out to the beach, you can wear them when you're going to the crew bar. And then on Royal Caribbean, we do have themed nights, like Caribbean nights, or two Caribbean shirts, different colors to bring out my eyes, you know. So with regards to the clothing, will go into the large bag. My uniform, I'm going to put it into my carry-on luggage, because you never know in terms of sometimes your luggage, your big luggage bags can go missing, simply you never know. So just to be on the safe side, my uniform will be going into my carry-on luggage bag just in case the big luggage gets lost, so that when I get onto the ship I can actually go to work and I don't have to make an excuse. So let's get packing. first back bag done and dusted. This is a big one. Alrighty, majority of the clothes, actually all of my clothes for 9 months. Okay. I think some of this clothing I won't be wearing, but we'll see. We shall see. Okay, another important thing that you would need to do is to also weigh the bags to see how much they weigh. Simply because you don't want to get to the airport and then element of surprise, bam, your bag is overweight. Now you have to repack, you have to move one thing to another bag and so on and so forth. So try and weigh your bags when you are home or before you even leave home so that you can make adjustments if needs be. Right, bag number one done and dusted, majority is just clothing in here. Moving on to bag number two. Right, so with bag number two, we are majority is just shoes. Okay, it's just shoes and a few other random stuff. Okay, the most important thing I personally believe you should be packing in quantity is underwear and socks.
Yep,
underwear and socks. So you're gonna need a whole lot of socks. I would generally encourage in terms of 8 pairs of socks, if not 9 pairs of socks. Underwear, as many as you please. Just, it's quite important to change it every single day. Yes. Then we've got shoes, okay, slides or flip-flops, whatever you want to call them. It's quite important to let the feet breathe, okay? Got my trainers in terms of techies, tennis shoes, whatever you want to call them. My working shoes, I've got 2 pairs of working shoes. Just in case one gets wet, then I have another one to replace it. Or in case one busts open during the contract, then I have another pair to interchange it with, right? And from there, a hat. I generally like hats, so yeah, hats. with the shoes also, formal shoes are quite important, okay? As I mentioned, that sometimes you go out for dinner on Royal Caribbean, you need to be wearing formal attire because you are going to guest areas. So for me as a personal trainer, I spend the majority of my day in tackies or in tennis shoes. So one pair of formal shoes is going to be enough for me. I don't need 2-3 pairs. Some people, their jobs require them to wear formal attire, so they're going to be taking 2-3 pairs of formal shoes and maybe only 1 pair of trainers with them. Right. Then from there, I have my laundry bag, okay? My laundry bag. Then I also have, like, fragrances. Fragrances, of course, you want to be smelling nice. Oh, yeah. Bluetooth speaker. This is quite important. It's almost like gold ownership. Music in your cabin, you can be playing music in your cabin. Of course, think of your roommate. Hopefully you all have the same taste, or you could be learning new music, who knows. I have my Bible, okay, quite important, devotion, morning, evening, because 9 months away from home, it's challenging. It is a lot physically, it is a lot mentally, it is a lot spiritually also. So this is quite important for me to stay grounded in the Word of God. Yeah. Then from there, I'll like to take in terms of stuff that will make me remember home. Okay, firstly, my South African flag. This was actually given to me by Terrence, one of the personal trainers on board that I worked with for my previous contract. So yeah, and also remember you do have themed nights on board cruise ships. So you tend to find that you might need to represent your country. Yeah. So I have my South African flag over here. And then my prized possession. This is my prized possession, honestly speaking. Kabuyelo, hi, 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 Kabuyelo, hi, hi, hi. Kabuyelo, masandawana. Tango is thank you. Yes. I hang this with pride, okay? I'm a massive Mamelodi Sundowns supporter, so I take this with me each and every single contract. Yeah, proud supporter, so this hangs proudly on my walls in my cabin. Yes, indeed. Then from there, I have this goodie box over here, if we can call it that. Sunnies. You're going to need sunnies because you are going to the sun. You might be going to the Caribbean. You might be going to Australia. You're going to need some sunnies. Then your name badge, nail clippers for personal hygiene stuff. Charger for your phones, for your laptops. And then also, you might also need maybe some medication just in case you have like allergies or sore throats. So medication also quite important to take. Now, when you're flying into a country, they might just take it away from you simply because of the rules that they have. So that's something to watch out for. Alrighty. A USB stick, just in case you need to get some documents from your manager. A notebook, notepad, quite important, especially for us who work in the spa. Because we are always jotting down notes. There's always a lot of things to learn. So a notebook so that you can take down some notes. Yes, indeed. So basically, this bag is like, it's my bag of tricks. Essentials that I personally feel that I need on the board. Toothpaste. Okay, you need toothpaste. So this is for me, this is my story. Okay, I personally, I don't want to get on board and spend money immediately on purchasing toothpaste, purchasing washing soap. Yeah, so what I tend to do, I tried this my previous contract that it actually worked fantastically for me. I try to take a bit of bulk stuff in terms of like, over here I've got two toothpaste and then some soap. I've got like quite a couple of soap over here, like three bars of soap. And then like roll-ons, deodorant, so that you smell nice and good. Yeah, and that is basically bag number two. Yeah, remember, quite important in terms of socks and underwear. Okay, shoes, Bluetooth speaker, sunnies, things that will remind you of home or things that are quite important to you. Yeah, let's pack bag number two. Man, I've been rambling. Okay, let's pack bag number two. Let's go. Done and dusted. Let's move on to bag number three, the carry-on bag. Okay, yeah, so as I said, uniform. Okay, literally what I've done, I've taken all my uniform and put it in my carry bag. None of my uniform is in any of these other two bags. Okay, cool. Then from there, I personally like to stay clean shaved on my head, so this is my shaving machines. Okay, for my cop, for my hair, to get the hair off. Then from there, water bottles. This is quite important, okay? Especially as a personal trainer on board cruise ships, I am exercising, so I do need to stay hydrated. Okay, water bottles. This is from my first contract, actually. One of my managers got me this. Yeah, my favorite manager by far. Okay, got me the bottle, and yeah, I've placed a few stickers on. Some stickers are coming off, but anyway. Water bottle. This is like a thermal bottle, keeps cold water cold and keeps hot water hot. Fantastic when you work on cruise ships. Okay. Then from there, shaker, in case we'll be needing to take protein shakes in case I want to get big and strong. So got my shaker over here. Then from there, headsets. Traveling, you are flying for more than 14 hours or so, this is quite important. Keep yourself entertained. My GoPro, okay, taking videos, yeah. And then from there, this is work in terms of manual for work, fitness business school. Then quite important, documents. Okay, this is very, very important. I should have started the video with this, but okay, because it's the most important thing. If you don't have these documents, you are simply not getting on board. And you'll be sent home. Okay, first and foremost, your passport. Without your passport, you cannot get on the plane. Okay, then from there, you're gonna need your vaccinations. Okay, some ships still require in terms of a COVID vaccine, your MMR vaccinations, your yellow fever, and all of that lovely stuff. Then from there, your cruise ship's medical. Your medicals, this is the most important thing once you get on board. The first thing that you're going to do when you get on board is you're going to hand over your medicals to the nurse or to the medical facility, and they are going to check it. Once they're happy, then you can proceed into getting into your room, into actually going to work and stuff like that. Okay, then from there, some certifications. Some ships require a couple of certifications. Remember I mentioned the STCW, so you need to bring your STCW certificates with you, and then yeah, so that you give it to the officials on board. Then from there, another notebook in case that other one that I have gets full. And that's pretty much
Yeah, ooh, my Siemens book also. Siemens book. This is basically like a log book of how long you were on board and what vessel you were on and stuff like that. Yes, right. Then from there, a book to read if you're a reader. If not, then yeah, a book to read or multiple books if you're a massive reader. And then a flip file, just in case you need to store a couple of documents. Okay, flip file. Yes, indeed. And that is literally is what is in my carry-on. Yeah. Right. Let's pack the carry-on, shall we? And that is literally what one needs to pack. That is how many bags?
I've got 3 bags.
Before I wrap up the video, this was a lifesaver for me, especially my first contract. As I said, that my luggage was just heavy. It was just massively heavy. So everything didn't fit into my luggage bags. So a friend on board actually gave me vacuum bags. So I would encourage everyone, get yourself 2, if not 3 vacuum bags, so that you can literally fit a whole lot more stuff into a smaller bag. You literally put all your clothing inside here, and then from there you seal it. You have to seal it, okay? Then from there you suck all the air out utilizing a vacuum. Then from there it compresses itself. Of course, the weight drops, it shrinks, it fits into a small bag, and bam, you've saved yourself the hassle of getting another bag. Okay, so vacuum bag, this was a lifesaver for me, especially on my first contract. Yeah, because I had to learn the hard way. My bags were still overweight, but everything fitted into a bag. I didn't have to throw anything away in the incinerator. So that was fantastic. Alrighty. So, okay, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. Alrighty. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Do not hesitate to ask. Hit me up on my Instagram. I'll screenshot my Instagram if you haven't already found me on Instagram. And remember to please like, share, and subscribe. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Danko is thank you.